need a boyfriend, and I can be that. Holler at me, hit me on my video chat, and let me reach out to you. And get...
If you could choose to work with anyone, like a dream collaboration, who would you go for?
Well, you know, we're big fans of Jesse J. Mm-hmm. So if you're watching for some reason, we would love to do a song with you.
Hey, Jesse.
What's up? But, there's so many people out here who we love. Tiny Tempo would be awesome. Chipmunk.
Chipmunk.
Loopy Fiasco, who's not from out here, but...
Okay. I'll put the word out. Now, when you're here, you're obviously doing your first, like, headlining gig in London tomorrow night at Shepherd's Bush.
Yes.
Before we came out here today, you guys are trending massively on Twitter.
I saw that.
It's crazy, right?
It's awesome.
I think being on Daybreak this morning helped that a little bit.
Thanks, Daybreak.
Yeah. Thank you, Daybreak.
And we love our UK fans. I mean, this is like our second home now.
So. But even so, it's amazing to see something like that just take off from... pretty much nothing, you know, in the space of a couple of days.
Well, the thing that always amazes me is that, like, we have fans in London. Mm. We all live in California, and this is, what, 6,000, 5,000 miles away, and the fact that people actually watch us this far away is never get used to it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Have you had kind of many encounters with UK fans yet?
Little bits. You know, one of the coolest experiences we had since we've been here was at the airport. This is only our second time. We were stalked by UK fans and stopped by American fans and
Austrian fans.
Spanish
people. I mean, it was nuts.
Kind of like the States, it's a huge melting pot of different people over here, and it's amazing to see that the show is in 85, 90 countries now. I mean, it's really, really cool.
It's a lot of fun. That's exactly why we're doing what we're doing, because it's a chance to have our message and have the show reach out to everybody. So.
Sure. Do you remember the first time that you got recognized?
I think
the first real time, it must have been in New York.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We
like,
did like a...
By yourself, like when you... Do you remember
it? I can't remember.
I don't remember which one.
One of the first times by myself that I really like got stopped other than like a look, it was like I was going to Mrs. Fields Cookies at the Galleria. It's a mall in Los Angeles.
Oh, yeah.
And literally I walk in and I hear like a dude's voice go, "No way!" And I look around and there's nobody there except for like a 28, 30-year-old dude behind the counter. And like I was surprised because a lot of our fans are younger.
Yes.
And I would look at him and I'm just like, "No way." But he was generally, like, he was a musician and he respected what we were doing. He was a fan and I thought it was really cool.
Oh, that's really nice.
Yeah.
So when I kick it to you, it ain't something that you've heard. I don't know what kind of guy that you prefer. I was going to ask you, of you guys, who's the kind of joker? Is there one of you that's like,
oh, man.
The funny guy?
Oh,
it depends. It depends on the mood and the type of day. I mean, we're all funny guys.
We all definitely laugh with each other all the time, but on set, I'd say Carlos pulls the most pranks.
Yeah.
Okay, that was
pranks, for better or worse.
Okay, and who's the most difficult to drag out of bed in the morning?
All of us. Yeah. Oh, man. It's hard to
Because I was going to say, you know, I saw you on set just a couple of weeks ago at Paramount, and I actually spoke to you very briefly, James, and you know, your workload is... pretty full on. There's not many days off, is there?
No, we take a lot of naps.
We try.
Early mornings, long days.
Yeah, we film single camera, so it takes quite a while, 12 to sometimes 20 days, hours a day.
20 hours a day?
Sometimes, that's like on a Friday night, but we average, I think, about 12 to 14.
Friday.
Yeah,
when everyone else is out partying, we're at work till like 3 o'clock
no,
in the morning. Yeah.
We shot a Halloween episode, and I remember coming to work, it was like 7 o'clock, it was dark, and when I left... No, sorry. It was light at like 7, 8 o'clock, and I left the studios at 10:30 a.m. the next morning. I didn't see night at all. I was just like, what is going on?
You must have been the most convincing Halloween character when you finished that.
Right? By the end of it.
Oh, he's a zombie.
Yeah. You're like, what? Yeah.
No, he's
not. Makeup
work.
But presumably it's all worth it.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. And coming here and seeing the fans just makes
it's
it all
the best job. Best job.
Fantastic. Well, thanks very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Good luck tomorrow night. I'll be there. So,
right on.
Don't make me nervous. No, we
will. All right, we'll try to hold this together, all right?
No pressure.
Okay, great.
Thanks a lot.
Awesome, man.